Hi, how do you do? Hope all of you are safe. I have already posted a video to explain non-restoring division algorithm for unsigned numbers. In this video, I am going to give the second example and explain how to do non-restoring division if negative numbers are given. Please click the follow button in my blog thyagarajan.blogspot.com to get the PPTs which will be posted by me. You also search YouTube with my name and subscribe to the YouTube channel to get videos posted by me for computer architecture. Right. Now, let us see the second example. In the second example, I am dividing minus 12 by 3. In this case, first you have to convert 12 to binary number. But before that, you should remember one point. That is, if there is a negative number in the dividend or divisor, then you just omit that negative value. Just assume that both are positive values. You proceed. Then finally, you decide the sign. For that, I will give a table. Based on the table, you have to decide the sign. Right? So, first convert 12, decimal number 12, to binary. How to convert? As I already told, you put 1, 2, 4, 8. These are the place values. I need 12. 12 means there is 1 8 and there is 1 4. So 8 plus 4, 12. So the remaining value should be 0. So this is the binary equivalent or binary value of 12. So that I am putting here. Then 3, you know, 1 1. Well, the binary value for 3 is 1 1. Since the dividend has 4 bits, you add 2 0 to make the divisor also 4 bits. But when you are storing the divisor in register B, you have to add one more 0 because the dividend has 4 bits, right? And divisor also 4 bits now. But in the register B, you have to add one more bit in the left side. So you can just put 0, and this should be stored in register B. Similarly, the register A should be initialized with 0, right? So A is initialized with 0000, 5 zeros, and B is initialized with 3 zeros, and B is having 3 zeros and 1. And what about Q? Q is, what is Q? Q is 12. That is this value. Q is 12. Q will be stored with this 12. 1, 1, 0, 0. Now, since we have to do A minus B also in the steps, it is better to find out minus B. As I already told, minus B is nothing but 2's complement of B. So to find out 2's complement, first you take the B value 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Here 4 zeros, but here 5 zeros. You take this value 5 zeros, 000, 0, 1, 1. Then to find out 2's complement, first you take 1's complement, then add 1, and this is the 2's complement, that is 1101. I have put that 1101 here. So if you need B, you use this value, right? If you need minus B, then you use this value, right? And Q value is stored here. A value, A register is initialized with five zeros like this. So this is the initial step, right? Now you are decrementing the step counter. What is the procedure? As we did in the previous problem, you have to shift left. Shift left means that is, this is the previous row. You shift this zero here, shift left. This one will come here, this one will come here, like that. This zero will come here and this zero will go out, right? So the rightmost place is blank now. Now you check MSB. Now MSB is zero here. So you have to perform A minus B. So what is A? A is this one. 0 0 0 4 0 1 A. Then what is minus B? Minus B is here. You put that one. Add these two. You will get this value 4 1 0. I will show it. So A is 4 0 1. This one, right? Then minus B is 1 1 0 1. Sorry, this one. Now you add 1 plus 1 is 2. That means 0. And there will be carry, and that will be added with this column. So you will have 1, and 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1. So the result is 4 ones and zeros, 4 ones and 0. So that should be stored in A. So that 4 ones, those 4 ones and 0 will be stored in A now. Now, what about Q? Q will be as it is. This 0 will come here. It will come here. But here, it is blank. So, what should we do? We have to decide whether it is 0 or 1. To decide that one, we are checking this MSB. If it is 1, this is the rule. If it is 1, what you have to put here? It is 0. Just complement of this one. You put 0 here. Now, step. Now what we have to do, you have to repeat the same three steps, these three steps. Shift left, A comma Q. So shift this left, it means you have to shift left, you have to shift left. Then finally this will go out. This one will come here, right? So after shifting left, you are having 1 1 0 1 and 0 0 in Q. And one blank position, right? Now how to decide what we have to do? So you check this MSB. Since MSB is 1, you have to perform A plus B. This MSB is 1, so you have to perform A plus B. What is in A? A is 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. Then plus B. Plus B means you have to take this one. This is plus B, 0 0 0 1 1, and you add these two. Let us see how to add 1 1 0 1, then 0 0 1 1. Now 1 plus 1 is 2, that means 0, and there will be carry 1. That carry will be added with this one, right? Again 2, so value is 0, right? Value is 0, and there will be carry. That carry will be added with this 1 and 0, so you will have 2, again 0, again you will have carry. You add that carry with this one, 2, so you will get 0, again you will have carry. So again 1 plus 1, 2, you will have 0, and there will be carry. So A plus B value is 1 5 0 1 5 0. But anyway, here you have 6 bits, but A can hold only 5 bits. So you take the least 5 bits, you put it in A, that is here, right? So you are performing A plus B and putting that value in A. It is indicated by this one. So now what we have to do, Q will be like this. This 0 will come here, this 0 will come here. But here it is blank. You have to decide whether this will be 0 or 1. So decide that one, check this MSB. So MSB is 0, so Q0 is equal to 1. Now this step is also over. Now decrement the step counter. It is, now the step counter is 1. What we have to do? The same three operations. Shift left, check MSB, do A plus B or A minus B. Then again check MSB, decide the value of Q0. So shift left. Shift left, this will come here. This will come here. This will come here like that. This will come here. This will come here. And this 0 will go out. So now what we are getting, so after shift left you are getting 5 zeros and in Q you have 001. Now you check this MSB. If MSB is 0, you have to perform A minus B. A minus B means A is what? 5 zeros, right? Minus B, from where you will get? Only from here, 111001, that you take. Now you add these two. How to add? You see here 5 zeros, then 111001. Actually 0 plus 11, 0 plus 00, 0 plus 11, here also 1, here also 1. So the result is 3 ones, 0 1. 3 1, 0, 3 ones and 0 1. This one. So this value should be stored here, right? Then what about Q? Q will come as it is. This one will come here. Now you have to decide only this value, because here it is blank in the previous row. So to decide this value, if MSB is 1, if MSB of A is 1, the Q0 value will be 0. So you have to put 0 here, right? So this step is also over now. Now again you are decrementing. The value is 0, right? Then shift left. Shift left means you have to shift left like this. This 0 will come here. This 0 will come here. 1 will come here. 0. This 1 will come here. This 1 will come here. This 1 will go out. Right? Now A has 11010. Now you are checking the MSB. Since MSB is 1, you have to perform A plus B. So A is 11010. What is B? B is this one. So B is 0001. So how to perform that? So 11010, 1 plus 0011. Right? If you add these values, you will get 11001. So 11001, and that value should be put here in this A. So 11001. Then what about Q? Q will be coming here. This 1 will come here. This 1 will come here. In the blank here, there is a blank space. What you have to put? So you check this MSB. This, since this is 1, you have to, MSB is 1, so you have to put Q0 is equal to 0. You put 0 here, right? So this step is also over. Now you are in the 0th step. Now you check this MSB, right? If this is 1, you have to perform A plus B. If this is 0, you need not do anything, as we did in the previous case, the previous example. So here this is 1, so this MSB is 1. So what you have to do? You have to perform A plus B. A is 11001, right? B is this one, 000011. So 0011 is here. You add these two, you will get value like this. I will show it. So 0001, 0001, 0011. You add these two. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 means 0. There will be carry, and that carry will be added with 0 and 1. So again, you will have 2. So here you have to put 0, and there will be carry, and that carry will be added with this 1. So again 2. You will put 0 here. Again there will be carry. That carry will be added with this 1. So again 2. Again there will be carry. That will be added with this 1. It will be 0. And you will have a carry here 1. That means you will have 1 000 000. 150s. Right? Now, there are 6 bits. So you take the least 5 bits. And that least 5 bits will provide the remainder. The remainder value is this least 5 bits. You take this value. So this will give the remainder. Then the quotient will be in Q only. In the Q you are having 0100. So that will be the quotient. So quotient is, you remember this, quotient is 0100 and remainder is 5 zeros, right? So you write it here. The remainder is 5 zeros, quotient is 0100. But anyway, as I already told, now this is the time to decide the sign for the remainder and quotient. So how to decide? You see this table. This is the table you have to use. In the case of dividend and divisor, if both are positive, then quotient will be positive, remainder will also be positive. If both are negative, then quotient will be positive, remainder will be negative. Then if dividend is positive and divisor is negative, then quotient will be negative, remainder will be positive. If dividend is negative, this is our case, dividend is negative, divisor is positive, then quotient is negative, remainder is also negative. So what is our remainder? Remainder is 0. So minus 0 means 0 only. But quotient is also negative. What is the quotient? 0100 means it is 4. Sorry. It is 4. 4 means you have to put minus 4. You have to put a minus sign here. So quotient is minus 4. Remainder is 0.